Rise of Citizen Analyst. Before we go into why we are talking about Citizen Analyst, let's look into what the organizations were doing before. So if you think about old organizations, older legacy organizations, where you know you had data, right? There was data, and then there were some very few people who had access to data, data scientists, analysts, whatever they're called, who could get access to data, who could manipulate data, and you know, sort of work everybody, like the marketing team, the product team, all sort of work via these people to sort of get access to data, interpret data, get insights about customer and product. And this was the old world that worked, all right. Now, with the advent of this new digital era, data is everywhere. Just like internet, with the advent of internet, every journalist, you know, every citizen became a journalist, right, with our blogging and with our tweeting. Same way, the new world of our new digital world, there is it's the same set of data which is, you know, they exist. However, now data is ever expansive, it's doubling up. The data is huge, it's there in every part of the organization. And there is not enough data scientists. That model of just having few people having access to data and doing analysis does not make sense because the decisions are being made all throughout the organizations. There's so much more data now. And so what you do need is these individuals, the others, the product, the marketing folks, the operations folks, these folks who are making decisions to be able to leverage the same data. They'll still work with these specialized data scientists for more complex stuff, but for the simple things, they should be able to leverage the data to make decisions. So these folks are called citizen analysts. Citizen analysts are essentially people who are citizens, product, marketing, business folks, who are able to leverage data, able to access data and manipulate data for their day-to-day workflow and make decisions, better decisions. Why is it important in this new digital world if the organizations which are successfully winning deals, making the best of the product, amazing ROE, customer experience, have a very good balance of data literate and data and citizen analyst. Their decisions are more and more optimized courtesy of these citizen analysts. So we are in the new age, where the citizen analysts are rising. But before we, as we talk about citizen analysts, there's more personas. If you're starting down the data literacy journey in your organizations, there are more and more, there's more profiles that you will encounter. So typically in an organization, you will have people who are data enthusiasts. So data enthusiasts are these people who are excited about data. They want to learn more. They want to use data, but they don't yet know how to leverage data. They're not afraid of data, they're excited about it, yet they don't necessarily know how to use it. So we have data enthusiasts. This continuum, by the way, is increasing data science skill, right? Then the next up in this continuum of data science skill is data literate, right? So data literates are these individuals who know the power of data, who understand the landscape of data science, and who also are able to interpret charts and graphs and so on, and who are able to see when a structured process is followed for decision making. So they know when data was used effectively in a decision making process. And any data literacy, a good data literacy program, can move people from data enthusiasm to data literate. And you need people, by the way. What I want to stress is for you to have a program where you are trying to make more and more of your organization data literate, you want to have them at the right place. You want to start with data enthusiasts, and we're going to talk about why it's important. And the third profile that you will come to is called citizen analysts. Now, citizen analysts are individuals, again, citizens, product marketing professionals, who know the power of data, who are, you know, not only skilled as data literate, but they go beyond. They're able to hands-on manipulate data and analyze to make decisions. in a tool called Excel using simple methodologies like correlation, aggregate. And so that's a good citizen analyst program. We have a program called ACCA. It's an accreditation program that we use in our data literacy project. And can move data literates to citizen analysts. So people need to be in some place in this continuum, data enthusiasts or data literate, for them to move towards citizen analysts. And then the last one, as you all probably can guess, is a data scientist. Now, data scientist is able to use more complex algorithm in complex advanced statistical tools, R, Python, SAS, whatever have you, and able to do more machine learning, advanced statistical, predictive model, linear regression, decision tree, more advanced techniques to solve more complex problems. And now typically citizen analysts don't move towards data scientists. Typically data scientists come from a different background, but you know, a good data science program can move people as well, can mature people. Maybe people from BI background or analytics background can move towards the data science, the data literacy program, depending on how you're structuring your data literacy program, they can move on. Two other personas that I want to talk about, which are very important in this journey. One is your data-driven executive, right? So your journey of data literacy starts from a data-driven executive. These are executives who believe in the power of data and who hold their team accountable for making decisions so that they can look back and say whether your decisions worked or not. So data-driven executives all starts with a data-driven executive. This whole journey, data literacy journey, starts from data executive. And the last person I want to talk about, and very, very important persona I want to talk about, is a data skeptic, right? So who are data skeptics? Data skeptics, as the name suggests, are people who don't buy data. They find data burdensome, waste of time, and they basically don't see the value of data. Do data skeptics exist in the organizations? In organizations who are stuck in the old realm, many, many people fall in this category. They are afraid of data, or they're skeptical of data, and they find it burdensome. Why am I having to, I'm going to talk about legacy organizations who we've been helping. People have tenure of 10 years, 15 years. These people have done certain things. I've always been in membership and I've done this way. Now you're saying I need to be able to use data. Now I need to be able to, make sense of data in an Excel sheet. They find it burdensome. So why are we talking about this? Data skeptics can derail your data literacy program before it started. And so they need to be, through a properly nurtured program, they need to be turned into data enthusiasts for your organization to move towards eventually what you want is in this digitally transformed organization, in this new organization, more and more people are going to be falling in these two data literate and analyst pockets. Citizen analyst bucket. More, because they are going to be in an organization which is fully optimizing all these decisions, people are either data literate or decision analyst. However, if you, and in an old organizations, there'll be more of those folks are data skeptics, and maybe you have some sprinkle of these other folks. But if there are more folks on data skeptics, you can imagine a conversation, a meeting room where most of the people are data skeptics, and in walks in a citizen analyst, what's going to happen? You're going to say, oh, this data nerd is back in the office, he's going to waste half an hour of our time. And you can imagine how that conversation would go. He or she would be up against a huge old momentum of no to the data, not trying to learn about our customers, just leave things as usual. While if you continue to do that, your competition is going to eat your lunch, right? So it's very, very important that in your data literacy program, you think about all these personas and how you're going to move people through this journey. Hope this was useful. Likes always, welcome.